if something happens in front, you go right into the back of some. So many times I face planted right into Rebecca's butt.
This is Dr. David Jordan. Our mission is to intercept a research pod from Mars.
Look how fast it's growing. Every single cell is a muscle cell and a nerve cell.
All muscle, all brain.
How smart is this thing?
What made you want to be a part of life?
People are in the making the movie, and the cast was wonderful, and a really interesting choices in the terms of the characters being played, and the script was terrifying, you know, and thinking about how someone was going to interpret that material, I just thought this would be a really fun journey to go on.
Obviously, you guys didn't went to space and film the movie, but you made the zero gravity seem so effortless and so realistic. Can you tell me how you did that?
First of all, thank you, because it's hard work. There's a lot of training before, because the whole film is zero gravity. So there's a combination of an incredible stunt team. We have acrobats. There's a bit of wire works. Seamus McGarvey, the photographer. I mean, he works the camera like no one. He's phenomenal. And then just training and trying to hold yourself in position with wires.
You know, each one of us, when we're flying around, has four people moving us or, you know, making sure that we're floating. And it's a combination, it's a real dance with a whole group of people. The fact that you could have four characters in one small space on wires moving around the way we do is a testament to, you know, all a group of talented people who wow. did it. Yeah, but it was, I think that's one of the most extraordinary things about the movie.
I have a question from the audience, and this was from Sabrina Feldhausen. She says, did you guys get a lot of bruises or injuries while making this movie because of the stunt work?
You know, Daniel, our director, designed the set, and Nigel, who's our production designer, designed the set to be as real as possible. You know, every switch was working, and every drawer had things in it, you know. Everything was edible in the canteen and the kitchen area, the ship. There were just lots of things about it. So, but unfortunately what that meant is that, you know, when a stunt went wrong, when wires would cross and you'd slam into a wall, you were hitting an actual wall, and there were tons of scrapes and bruises that came about in this. I mean, I found myself following Rebecca a lot, so I was behind her, and you know, when there are wires behind each other on a rig, if something happens in front, you go right into the back of some. So many times I face planted right into Rebecca's butt, which is not a bad thing, honestly. It's much better than hitting a wall, which right. I also did many times. Yeah.
Corinne Fag wants to know, what did you do on set between takes?
Between takes, I was still hovering.
Really?
Yeah, to stay in it. You walk off and then you sit. And you sit and you move a little bit and you listen to lots of music and fun.
Do you still have that?
I try not to, because the cameraman here would be very annoyed if I start moving out of frame.
If you ever could go to space, would you want to go, and what would you like to do?
You know, at this point, I think the going to space and the journey there is pretty precarious and a bit dangerous. And so, no, it's never been a deep desire of mine, though I'm definitely fascinated by it from afar, you know? And I think the people who go there are just extraordinary right. human beings.
Yeah.
If I was a trained astronaut and the spaceship was massive and I knew what I was doing, then yes. But I think the idea of being separated from Earth, the beauty of looking back would be thrilling. But I think I'm just happy here. I like knowing that when I jump, I come down again.